A mom drank 3 gallons of water in 2 hours. This is what happened to her brain. KC is a 28-year-old woman presenting to the emergency room, unconscious. Her husband Josh tells the admitting nurse at admission that she had suffered at least 2 seizures in the past 30 minutes. You see, KC had been practicing in a radio show competition, Hold Your Wee for a Wee, where contestants would drink up to 3 gallons of water in 2 hours, and the last person to urinate or vomit would be the winner of a shiny Nintendo Wii. Clearly, this was for gags on behalf of the radio station and at the expense of its contestants, but KC was determined she was going to win the Nintendo and be able to play it with her kids. Immediately after finishing all 3 gallons of distilled water, KC complained from a severe nausea, and in order to hold back the urge to vomit, she was found to clench the arms of her chair. Within 20 minutes, KC was easily crowned victorious in the challenge, and her husband began to drive her home about an hour after finishing all that water in the car. She begins to cry. She's suffering a massive headache and tells her husband, "I am coming out of my skull." She feels pressure push against her eyes and reports that the vision in her left eye is going dark. Her husband drives quickly so they can get home and she can take a nap, because they both believe she can sleep it off. Interestingly enough, after drinking all that water, she has no urge to urinate or vomit. KC goes to her bed to lay down while her husband begins to prepare dinner. Dinner's ready, it's only been 30 minutes and the husband watches TV and lets his wife sleep. It's here in the bed that KC silently suffers her first seizure. Unknowingly, Josh watches TV for another hour, trying to be considerate to his wife, who he believes is sleeping but is actually unconscious and suffering seizure every 20 minutes as he finally feels it's time to call her for dinner. An hour later, he goes to see her and finally sees her suffer yet one more seizure. 911 is called. Inside the ambulance, Casey's 6th seizure is seen by the paramedics as she arrives to the emergency room. Given the patient's immediate past medical history, there is several clues as to what's happening. Any doctor will be able to easily identify that KC is suffering from acute hyponatremia. Hypo meaning low, natro meaning sodium, or more formally natrium. Emia meaning presence in blood, low sodium presence in blood. Acute meaning that there are no underlying pathophysiologic conditions that are leading to this problem aside from the 3 gallons of water that are inside her body. Which leads us to the first clue. Josh tells the admitting nurse that KC had not vomited or urinated since the contest ended, which means that there hasn't been a net flow out of her body. The 3 gallons of water are hanging around somewhere inside of her. That water is important to note because KC is a woman. The female body is on average made of about 50% water compared to male bodies, which are typically 60% water. So if the female body is typically made of less water and contains more fat, which doesn't mix with water at all, where are those 3 gallons of water inside KC's body? Well, there is a bit of basic chemistry to be known here. The fluid in your body is a soup of several chemicals. In this case, the most important being sodium, which is 1/2 of this table salt. The interesting thing about sodium is that it creates something called an osmotic gradient, which means that wherever sodium is, water will flow towards it. So, low sodium presence in blood, if she hasn't urinated or vomited since she drank all 3 gallons of water, how is it possible that there is low sodium? Nothing has left her body, so there shouldn't be less sodium present, right? Yes. But the water in your body is made of 0.9% sodium. So for every 1 liter of water, there are 9 grams of sodium. Most of the water in your body is inside your cells. Then KC's cells must have lots of water flowing into them. This would mean that her organs, like her liver and her stomach, are starting to swell with water. That should be okay though, because your abdomen is soft. So, water would be flowing into her heart and her muscles. But those aren't enclosed in heart space either, so it wouldn't be too much of a problem if they swelled up inside. But what is a problem is the brain. It's enclosed inside a heart space called skull. Brain only has space to expand 8% in volume until it starts to push up against the bones in your skull. As the water keeps flowing into the sodium-rich cells of KC's body, her brain starts to crush up against the size of her skull. smashing blood vessels as it expands, preventing blood flow in, causing hypoxia or deprivation of oxygen. As the flow of blood is disrupted to Casey's brain, parts of it start to necrosis or quite literally die. This damage apartment brain expansion is known as herniation and means permanent brain damage. Incredibly rare, the reason she suffered the acute hyponatremia is because of something called SIADH syndrome of inappropriate antidiuretic hormone. A diuretic is something that causes you to urinate, so an antidiuretic is something that prevents you from urinating. Do you remember that severe nausea she complained after drinking all 3 gallons? Well, since your body thinks it's going to lose a lot of fluid in vomiting, it releases a hormone telling your organs to hold on the water that it already has. It wasn't appropriate in Casey's case, and not only did she hold on the water that was already inside of her before drinking the 3 gallons of water, but also added the 3 gallons, and because in this context SIADH is very rare, it was an accident that had happened to Casey and not the other contestants on the radio show. But still, it's never anything you should ever want to try. Luckily for Casey, no herniation occurred in her brain, and the 3% sodium infusion was enough to solve the hyponatremia and draw water out of her brain. Upon regaining consciousness, she was able to urinate and proceeded by saying hello to her husband. This case was originally presented at a grand round in central New Jersey. It's based off of a true story. Thank you so much for watching. Take care of yourself and be well.